To prepare our application to receive push notifications, first we are going to go into our files and we are going to look for the manifest file. You can see that the manifest file is inside the source folder. So at the same level, you are going to create a new file, and that file is going to be called Firebase Messaging SW. SW stands for Service Worker. Before we move forward, we are going to go to the angular.json file. Inside of the assets, you're going to find where it's declared in the manifest file, and right below that, you're also going to add the new messaging service worker. This is going to make sure that when the CLI is building your application, it picks up these two files right here. Once that's done, let's go back to our messaging service worker. In here, we're going to import two packages. As you can see, we have the core of the Firebase SDK, and we also are going to import the Firebase Messaging SDK. Then we are going to initialize our application. For that, we use firebase.initializeApp and we pass our credentials. If you don't know where your credentials are, you can navigate to console.firebase.google.com. You go into your application, and in here you go into the settings, project settings, and you're going to find the credentials for your application here. So let's copy this object. And now you can use it here in your service worker. Next, we are going to create an instance of the messaging package. And then we are going to go to our web manifest file and we are going to add a new property. This property is going to be called GCM sender ID. And this number is going to be unique for every single application out there because this isn't really your sender ID. This is a Google Cloud Messaging's sender ID. So it's the same for every one of us. Then we go back to our service worker, and right after our initialization of messaging, we are going to create a background handler. This is going to listen to the push notifications in the background, and here it's not doing anything. It's just logging to the console, whatever it gets on the payload. In this background handler, we are going to customize our notification for a bit. So here we're going to create a variable called notification title, and we are going to get the value from payload.notification.title. Then we are going to create a new object called notification options, and it's going to have a body, that's the body that comes in the notification payload, and an icon. This icon is pointing out to our own assets file to the 72 by 72 pixels version of our icon. And then we are going to return inside of this handler a new show notification, and it's going to show the notification title and the notification options. We could technically skip that part, but we want to customize it a bit because inside of the payload, we had the title and the body, but we didn't have the icon. So we are adding the icon here before showing the push notification to the user. After that's done, we're going to create a new service. So for that, let's go ahead and open our terminal and we can type Ionic generate service, and we're going to create a service called push notification. So let's open our push notification service, and here we are going to import Angular Fire Messaging, and we're going to import the Firebase Messaging namespace. For this to work, we also have to go to our app module, and where we are declaring Angular Fire, we are also going to say, okay, I'm not only using Firestore or storage, but I'm also going to be using Angular Fire Messaging, and it's come from the messaging package. And then you also get to register it in the imports. Then we can save and close this file and go back to our push notification service. Here we are going to create a class variable to store our push notification token, and we are going to inject the Angular Fire Messaging service to our constructor. Then we're going to create a new function called request permission. And in this function, we are going to use Angular Fire Messaging to request the user's token. This is an observable, so we can actually subscribe to this token. So here we get back the token and we can create an arrow function when we can say that our push notification token is equal to that token we got there. And we also can create a function to handle the error when we can just say, okay, let's log to the console that something bad happened. Then we're going to create a second function called receiveMessage. And here we're going to call messaging.messages, and it's also an observable that we can subscribe to. Inside of the subscription, you are going to get the payload for the message that's incoming. And in here, you can do whatever you want with that message. Right now, we are just going to log it to the console. But if, for example, you are sending a link inside of your push notification and you want to navigate the user to that link, you can do something like window.location, and you can assign the link that's coming inside of the push notification. You could also inject the Angular router into the service and handle that with the Angular router itself. Now that that's done, we can go and close these files and go back to our app component. In here, we want to import the service that we just created, and we also want to later inject it into our constructor. Then in our constructor, we are going to call the two functions that we created inside of the push notification service. One will request the permission to access push notifications, and the other one will handle all the incoming messages.